Hey, it's Dave Wyman from Danny, Dave, and Moore, and it's another edition of Football 101. We're going to take a look at a punter. Now, I've made fun of kickers in the past, and just because we used to as players. When I was in Denver, we made the punters and the kickers make coffee, and it had to be fresh or else we'd give them a really hard time. But hey, look, they're football players too. They're just different, you know. I mean, I would come in from after an hour and a half, two-hour meeting, and, you know, those guys would be balancing their checkbooks or running errands for their wives. And so I was like, yeah, you're not really a real football player, but mostly just joking. I proclaimed Michael Dickson, our punter, a real football player after this play on the air during the broadcast because I thought this was a great play. And this is really more about Pete Carroll and his coaching, which we'll get to later. But what happened on this, and you know, I remember during the broadcast thinking, I wonder if they might take a safety here. The only reason I didn't think that they would is because if you get a punt blocked, it's likely to go out the back of the end zone, which is going to be a safety anyway. The likelihood of them recovering it in the end zone, you know, not very high, but you want to be safe. And if you give up 2 points, they've still got, you know, it'd be 28-16 and they'd still be down two scores. So it made a lot of sense. A couple of things that happened during this play that I think gave Michael Dickson a chance to actually run it. And remember Deshaun Shedd, he was the outside rusher here. And so, and first of all, the reason why, you know, this was maybe take a safety instead of punt it away is typically Michael Dickson lines up at about 16 yards. And he was only 13 yards. The only reason I thought they might punt it away is just because he's an athlete and he could probably, you know, he's got quick twitch muscles and could, you know, kick it away in a hurry. But yeah, usually he's back here. And so he was standing right on the back of the, you know, the end zone line there, making sure he didn't step out. And so, yeah, he takes the snap and then just starts going this way. Well, what happened here was Shedd was, I think he was supposed to be like the contain rusher. Well, Delano Hill came up and pinned him and walled him off. So as he's running this way, you know, he sees basically a wall. The other thing is the snapper, Tyler Ott, he turned around and was looking at him and was kind of watching him. So I think Michael Dickson could see Ott and know that, hey, I've got either a lead blocker or a guy who would seal off anybody that's, you know, going to chase him down. Out here on the outside, Akeem King, who just did a great job all day on punt coverage. He ran his guy off and didn't really get a block, but his guy came up and actually ended up making the tackle, but not before Michael Dickson was able to get there. So he runs along and then all of a sudden just makes a decision and hits it. Tyler Ott ended up peeling back, and he didn't block anybody, but he just made sure nobody was going to get there. So there was a huge area here, big gap, and you know, he just made a football play. And that's one of the things I want to talk about with Pete Carroll, why I like him so much and wish I could have played for him, because he always coaches players to in a positive way. He coaches them to make plays and tells them, look, you're supposed to make plays. And, you know, he does everything in such a positive way. I always say this, and if you watch Football 101, there's three parts of every play. One is getting lined up so that you can execute your responsibility in the offense or defense. The second thing is executing your responsibility. If you have a gap, get in the gap. If you're supposed to drop to a zone, get to that zone. The third part is being a football player and making plays. And sometimes that goes outside of instruction. You know, like, for example, linebackers, you're not supposed to run underneath a block. So if a guy's blocking you this way and your gap is here, you're not supposed to go this way. But if you can go that way and make a play and make a tackle, and Bobby does it all the time, go make a play. And Pete encourages that. Same thing with a defensive back dropping back and jumping a route. Gets an interception, you know, and it's a risk a little bit. But he encourages his players to make plays. And if you see something, go be a football player. And that's exactly what Michael Dickson did there. And so I think, you know, a lot of that, and that's why Pete was so fired up. Now, I don't think he's going to do this again. I think everybody's going to be looking for it. But this kid who they moved up in the draft to get out of Texas, they moved up in the fifth round to get him. I know there was lots of criticism, but the punter, Michael Dickson, I think's made a case for being possibly the most valuable rookie on this team. And it's all because Pete encouraged him to make a football play.